iMac, microphone. Okay, I think we have audio now. All right. It's supposed to be this doodad, but that's okay. Other things that needed to happen, we're just like getting everything figured out really quick, but I have a bunch of stuff all in one spot right here. And I'm going to grab out a couple pieces of paper and we'll get started. So we're gonna be reusing, oh, like over a little, there we go. We're gonna be reusing some paper so it's like upcycled a little bit. Here they are from yesterday. We just did like a little tester sketcher to see. And this paper is not good with water. Good to test your water absorbency for whatever you're using. And cheers, we're gonna have a little breakfast. All right. If there's any issues, just let me know and we'll just do a little artwork. And if you're tuning in from your phone, you can also tune in through YouTube and you can do it that way. If you wanted to hear and see everything that's going on, like on the screen. It looks pretty good. I think so. This is our first live stream from the studio to Robert's gallery. And Robert's art gallery is located at UW-Whitewater, University of Wisconsin-Whitewater in Whitewater, Wisconsin. They're, I think, they're about 45 minutes away from Madison. But anywho, here is what we're doing today. Just a little sketcheroo. And I might set a little timer as well for us so that we can get more done. Let's pull this up just a little bit. There. I have two cameras right now on what we're doing. So it's a little weird, but we'll make it work. Okay. And then also gonna just pull Libby's picture up. I'll pull the pictures up on my iPad as well, so then I can actually see it with a little bit more detail. Okay. I think we should always, maybe we should always start with a little sketch of Willy, because I feel like the very first one is always my least favorite. Wait. We're gonna find Willy. Willy's in there. Perfect. What is going on with this thing? Maybe I just use the computer. Whatever happens, we'll make it work. right, we'll just start out our day with this little sketch here of Willy. Willy is the mascot for UW-Whitewater. They are the Warhawks. He's got feather fingers. Cute. Okay, we'll get those in there. And then it looks like he has like four fingers here. He's supposed to be pointing at you in this picture, so we'll probably end up doing a bunch of drawings of Willy by the end of this series and just really figure out how to get that perfect pointing with a feather hand. think it looks like Willy. Okay, so this is Willy the mascot of UW Whitewater, in case you're just joining us. It's pretty cute. I have an art gallery exhibition up right now at UW Whitewater, Roberta's Art Gallery. And it will be up until May 7th, the end of the semester. If you're in Wisconsin or you get around to Wisconsin, go check it out. It is the first. Almost the first 175 pieces. A couple of them are not there, but for the most part. A couple of them sold early. So they'll just join us when we get to the final exhibition, which we will get to. Mark my words, we will. But drawing is one of those foundational skills that everyone should have, including myself. And a little bit about myself, too, in case you're new here. I started painting and drawing during the pandemic as a way to help myself, just like alleviate some of the pains of life. And I had just had a brand new diagnosis as well of bipolar disorder. And I decided after a life, like really almost a lifetime of being on a lot of medications for like antidepressants and things like that, and birth control, like being a woman, you know, I couldn't handle taking more pills. So I told the doctors that I refused the bipolar medications, which were like Lithia. They've had a lot of really strong drugs that they wanted me to take every day, all day, for the rest of my life. And I was really not about to do that. Everybody's got to do what, you know, works for them, and that just didn't work for me. So I discussed options and decided to be unmedicated. And so drawing, painting, connecting, right? Like talking to people, talking to you. Thanks for hanging out today. That's my medicine. So thank you for being here and being a part of really cool artwork and creation and friendship. Right now we're adding in the shadows. And I'm changing. You'll notice that some of them are really tight together, the little lines. And so it should indicate a darker value. Some of them are further apart. I didn't pay attention the whole time, so we're getting there. But the Garden of a Thousand Faces was a project that really got me through some really dark times. And meeting people and getting to speak to y'all about who you are really helped me figure out more about who I am. And I hope that we continue doing that work. That's the plan, at least. And talking to one another and being able to be inspired to get up and take good care of ourselves and drink a lot of water and make healthy choices. Get some good rest, you know, and be able to do it each day. So, thank you for being here with me. It means a lot. So this one, he just looks kind of dead stare. I'm not sure. There's gonna be many expressions of Willy in this project, I can tell. Part of the gallery installation is that we're doing live streams together, and let's see, we want to have like an arch that way, but we're gonna do it like this. We have a lot of renditions of this right here. I see it. Hi, Vina. Okay, we are gonna keep on going. I think Willie would like this portrayal of them. Okay, we'll sign it. And there you go. There is Willie, the mascot for UW Whitewater. Probably the first of a lot. First of many. That was a good warm up. Okay, we're gonna get into our next piece. All right, I'll pull that one up. And this is Peyton. Peyton is from Madison, Wisconsin, and is in a digital marketing major at UW Whitewater. Now, I will draw these until I feel like I got them right. This is really practice for me. And then an entire nose on here. And then a lip that pops out a little bit and a smile. The bottom lip. We're probably gonna redo this one, just say. Just because there were really tight little angles in there that I didn't get right away. But I could be telling stories. We'll see. We'll see. We're not going to lose hope. They're like cute little tortoise shell sunglasses. So I also did include a link to, there's an ear here. I did include a link in the YouTube video, so if you find my YouTube channel, you can submit your own photo for this project that I'm working on. This is specifically for UW-Whitewater students, staff, and alumni. And if that doesn't sound like you, that's fine. In the bio that we have on TikTok here and on YouTube, I have a little form you can fill out. It's a Google form. I don't sell your information or share it with anybody as well, so if you're worried about that. I grew up in a very paranoid household regarding technology and information and data, so I respect that. But I will send you an email if I end up painting you. And I paint quite frequently. We're just kind of getting back into it. I had kind of, I'm like hibernated for the winter, so to speak. Really, I took some time off to spend with my mother and on myself. And taking time off is not good for me. It just isn't. Like, mentally, not good. Some people can do it. I can do it for like a short amount, but after about a month and a half, a month, I get really stir crazy. So that's what I did. But it is good, take breaks, listen to your body. I might actually like this one a lot, by the time we're done. I think I'll like all the ones we do. Right, everyone, tap on that screen, send a little like, subscribe to the channel, and drink something. I'm drinking coffee right now, but I'm gonna have a water afterwards. We gotta stay hydrated. In the picture, her face is just like angled a little bit more, like her chin is forward. And the chin being forward pulls the forehead back more. Right now, I have her face sort of like straight. Which kind of makes this an awkward angle since that one's not. It's like terminating the motion. Everything that we do is just a learning process. It's another little piece of the puzzle. Get these hands in there. Thank you for tapping on the screen and liking the live. think hands are really hard specifically because we see them every day. So if there's just a little something off about them, you'll notice it and they'll become quite wonky quite quickly. That's okay. Like that was a little wonky right there, that area. I'm gonna leave it vague rather than adding a lot of detail though. And that I think will save us. And then I'm just gonna go and add some of the shadow, and that will also save us. So now you can't really, like, it's there, but you can't really see it. And then a trick we can also do is we can just cover it up with the shadow of our sunnies. She's got sunglasses in her hand. And you guys, you can critique me all you would like. You know, it helps me to be able to see what's going on in the images and what I'm doing. So if you just tell me that things are beautiful and it's great, that's nice of you, but it does not help me grow. And I value growth and honesty over being nice. And a lot of people don't get that. I live in the Midwest, so a lot of people don't understand what that means. And that's fine. It was a very quiet day. It was always really quiet, and I went to University of Wisconsin, Stevens Point. And while I was there, for a while I was in the interior architecture program. Oh my gosh. Nobody wanted to critique anybody and like help each other. They were like, it's so good. And I was like, is it? Is it so good? Or are you afraid of me? And usually it was like people are afraid to say something. Be disagreed with or say something and make someone feel badly. As long as you're not doing it from a place of like, I want you to feel badly, you're doing it good. That's all. That's all that is. You're learning here too. I'm so glad. I'm glad that we're here together. It's a process, you know? We're figuring it all out. And maybe not even all of it, but just some of it today. We don't have baby steps. And also, like, for the people who are being sketched, there's really no shame in me learning something while we're making the artwork. And if I don't like one, I will redo it. If you don't like it, let me know, but kind of tough cookies because it's about learning, so we're gonna grow together. No, but I might redo it. Maybe. Depends on, you know, why. Why is it that we are not a fan of it? But use your agency and just tell me what's going on, and we can make it happen. Now, one of the really beautiful things about the Garden of a Thousand Faces is that because we're doing 1,000 portraits, it forces me to move on. You know, if I ever feel like I really like struggle with something, that's fine. There's another one to do. And it's not so much to say like it doesn't matter, but more so to say that I've learned something. And that I will apply that then to the next one. The next painting, the next drawing, the next portrait, the next human interaction, you know? It's okay to fail. It is okay to fail. It is not okay to not get back up and keep going. And it, but it is okay to take breaks, you know. You can, have you ever fallen on ice? I have multiple times. Sometimes I'll just lay there in defeat just for a second, you know, just to realize what is it that just happened and mentally go through the checklist of did I waddle like a duck or like a penguin, you should say. Probably not. And then make some calculated choices before getting back up. It's tough, you know? Same thing with breakups, okay? Sometimes you just kind of lay there for a moment, sit there for a moment with yourself, and you're like, all right, that happened. Now what? This was going into this hood. I think you weren't here yet, but I was talking about the fact that this is a little wonky because in the image, this person, Peyton, is like, her angle of her face is more like this. So her chin should come out, her forehead should go back, and then right now it's like a terminating up and down. It should be giving more fluid motion. And then it would make sense as to why their neck is sort of poking out a bit. But I didn't, so it's okay. And then there's just a little shadow back there. And then there's a hood right there. So you can see a little bit of what's going on in the image. And I didn't really get into the textures of the clothing. My focus was mainly making sure that we could get everything else in there. Okay, we have a hand here. Let's get this hand in. A very dainty little ring there. I'm just gonna wipe the end of this pen off. Seems like a little bit of the oily nib getting a little bit chunky. Don't like that. Okay, then we're gonna pull this sweater down. It's kind of a puffy jacket situation. Are we seeing the puffiness of that jacket there? And I'm gonna just woo, pull this in a little bit. And then we can, right now it's like it's very contained. I like that kind of sweeping motion that we're getting across. It goes kind of oval shape. We're not going to continue this line down. That would be the coat, just as an artistic choice. And as another artistic choice, whoops. We're not going to add any extra lines to the face or to the neck area. I just want to keep it really simple. Just make sure that that ear is really easy to tell what it is. And then we'll just add a couple more lines into the hair there. Yeah, so that's Peyton. I like that. Maybe the only thing I would probably do now is to add another line here. And then here we should have a couple of little up and downs, which kind of reinforces this motion that we have going across. And then I don't wanna smear myself, but let's also get over here. Some depth. This darker value is gonna push this arm back behind the coffee more. We'll work on our cross hatching. It should be very clean. There you go. All right, there's our drawing of Peyton. And these are just the pieces of paper that came with our frames. You know, we don't need to waste anything. And then I'll just sign it. Green for green goodies. I like it. I could have made her neck go back just a bit to give it more energy, but we know now. Okay, after Peyton. And we have one more hour today. This is Annie. Annie is an art studio major with a minor in criminology, and she's from Wauwatosa, Wisconsin. Where should we start? Let's start with the nose this time. The less lines that we do for these portraits, the better. Then we're going to go here to over here for the smile. And our nose will come here. And the angle that we're getting is very much like from the top. And then the sides of the mouth are usually right about where the pupil is on each side. So we can kind of just use that to gauge. And then her left eye, just a little bit back from the other eye. We'll give some little wispy eyelashes there. And then her eyebrow here kind of follows the eye socket. It's smaller. Then for this area, we really want to. The pen got a little juicy right there. That's okay. Come in and just give a little bit of a 3D-ness here. And then got very full cheeks that kind of come down to here. And again, we're at like a different level angle here. Oh my gosh. Juicy. The pen was the pen. It got juicy for a second. Just making sure that. I know we said don't add a bunch of lines to the face. Breaking all the rules. I just don't want it to be flat. That's the only thing. I want the dimension to still be there. And then to get an ear here. Now I feel like I have to go back in. I don't want to just have like random lines on her face. Also, she's got more like freckles on her face as well. We're gonna go darker here. Really emphasize those eyes. And then what we didn't do is like any teeth. We left room though, so we can. Her teeth aren't super big, so we have to make sure to be careful when we do that. a little necklace on. It's kind of a dainty thing. And she's wearing this sort of a blouse. A blouse that's got like a fringy frill to the edge of it. Put that in there. Doesn't have to be perfect, we just want it to be in there. Now, if I were to redo this portrait, like I often say, I would probably less lines on the face, do pull her eyes closer to her nose, just like millimeters, like not a lot, but a little bit. Giorgio just walked in. George. Come here. Oh. You just came in here to cough, I guess. Uh-oh. George, what do you need? What do you want, boy? If you're new here, Giorgio is my chihuahua. Loves to put his input into everything, which is fine. Giorgio, hi, good morning. And you just woke up? Looks pretty good. But yeah, because of the angle, I don't know, in my head I was like pulling the eyes up a little bit more than they should be. The eyes can come down just slightly. You see what I'm saying? Ugh, I want some alcohol markers so that we can paint draw. Last night when I was doing my nails, I went online and I was watching some videos on YouTube, and
got inspired that maybe we should try out the homeworkers. I have never been like excited about them. But maybe that's a fun move. I'm just gonna show. Oh, trace paper. Yep, I have a little. A trace paper we can look at, or else I will get some tracing paper. Lots of papers, but not tracing paper there. Okay, we'll add tracing paper to the list of things to get so that I can lay it over, and then we can see what we would do a little differently. Next. Thank you to everybody who submitted their photos so far. If you still want to submit a photo, you can. There's a link in the description to be able to do that. We'll be live until noon Central Time in order to sketch together. Boy. See this one, hold on. Oh, here it is. They're in order. Excuse me. Are you a morning person? Or more of like a midday or an evening person? Okay. I feel like after that one, I do kind of want to do just a little bit of a pre-sketch situation. It can be erased really easily with the pencil. Let me find. There we go. The best pencils are Ticonderoga pencils, hands down. All right, and getting this angle that Grace has her head at. Grace is from Whitewater, Wisconsin, and is studying digital marketing. And then her body is sort of like at another angle. So we have two different angles here. There's gonna be some flower situations over here. And we'll go from here. Down. And then this way. Body's gonna be over here. You're There's going to be a bunch of hair in this area. Less hair over there. Okay. All right. see where her eyes should have been. I feel like her eyes should have been just lowered a little bit in this image. We'll keep it going. We'll come back into her hair. But for now, let's get some of the torso added in as well. Alright, it's 11:42. We're gonna do one more. And we'll do this one really, really quick. I was doing them a little slower, in part because not a lot of people have submitted their face yet, but you can. Ooh, I did her yesterday. You still can submit your photo if you'd like. Let's see if we did it any better. And I think we're gonna start doing some of those timed ones again. I'll set a little timer and we'll just kind of like work until the timer's up.
I feel like we're gonna do her portrait a lot of times just to like litmus test and see how much progress we've made. And over the course of the next, oh, excuse me, like 3 weeks, we'll be continuing this project. 4 weeks, excuse me. And we'll just keep on drawing, I should say. And we'll do paintings too, but for this, we'll do more of the drawings. Drawing is a foundational skill of painting. If you can't draw, it'll be a lot harder to paint. At least to paint things that other people recognize and that you recognize. But that doesn't mean you can't do it, you know? So always find a way to do the things that you love doing, even if it doesn't look very good. And you'll find yourself getting better. You'll find yourself knowing more about what it is that you like and that you don't like about a portrait or about a drawing or a scene or a composition, you know? And you'll find out how to do it with more grace and ease and confidence. Yeah. We're getting somewhere. And we might do some colored pencil drawings too, just switch it up and try something new. This part of her. To not be so forward. And now I feel like I have to do the whole thing like that. Here we go. Hi, Giorgio. Okay, Giorgio is telling me that it's time to go. There's like 4 minutes left until noon. George, it's okay. It's okay. I'll show you really quick what we did today. So we have Christina. Oh, and I don't think I told you she's an English major with a psychology minor. And she's from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Okay, Giorgio, it's okay. Hold on, honey. He's not satisfied. Okay, and then we have Grace from Whitewater and Annie from Wauwatosa, Peyton from Madison, and we did one of the mascot only today. Thanks for hanging out with me, and we'll check in with you next time.